It's about 3:45, April the 15th, a Monday, week before Easter, and I've headed out of London, just beyond the edge of London, to Gerrards Cross, Buckinghamshire, county of my birth. And I've come here because I want to go to the Bronze Age or Iron Age hill fort or Bulstrode Camp, a really famous place. And when people hear of my interest in prehistoric remains or pre-Roman remains, hill forts and earthworks and that kind of thing, and then they hear that I'm from Buckinghamshire, they assume I know this site very well. But actually, I've not really been here, not consciously anyway. Gerrards Cross Common. Just been talking to my dad on the phone, and he did a lot of gardening work around this area, and he was telling me how I can get to the hill fort by going down Camp Road through the car park of the Bull Hotel. Bull Hotel, quite a famous landmark on the A40. I'm really looking forward to this. And then once I've been to Bulstrode Camp, we can go for a wander on towards Beaconsfield. Who knows, maybe even down to Wooburn if we have enough daylight. Here's where we're going, Camp Road. Private, well, I'm afraid I'm going to have to ignore that. This is my entry to the hill fort. These gateposts here feel incredibly apt for the fact we're about to enter the hill fort. Should be a path somewhere over there. Look at it, there it is, in this private estate. So my dad was actually telling me that he did some gardening work actually in Camp Road, and this is where we are now. We're on Camp Road. It goes in a circle around the hill fort. He laid a dry stone wall in one of the houses right near here somewhere. I wonder if it was that one there. Here we go. Footpath that leads to the camp. There's a sign here. What does it say? It's Gerrards Cross Parish Council, Bulstrode Camp. That's what it's actually called. Let's read it out, shall we? This ancient hill fort of 26.38 acres was acquired by the Parish Council in June 1952 for the preservation as an ancient monument and a public open space for the rest and recreation of the parishioners. And there's more information here. One of the characteristics of this type of hill fort is it would have had a double outer ditch. Here's a ditch here. I don't know if that is the other bank there on the other side or whether that's a more recent recreation. On the top of the bank here, you can see how steep it is. Going back down there into the ditch. And that's the path I just walked up. And here it is, Bulstrode Camp. It's a vast area, isn't it? As a kid growing up, oh my God. My lens is so dirty. As a kid growing up, actually not very far away from here now, about 5 or 6, 7 miles away, I was always really fascinated with the past. It felt like something that was very tangible, that was all around us. That's why I get so excited about sites like this, which on the face of it may just look like a large field, but it contains so much living history within it. We don't really know where they built this camp. It's not sure whether it was used as like an animal stockade. It's very unlikely to have been a fort, like a fortification in the sense of it being for military usage. But it was definitely a fortified enclosure, but it could well have been used for grain and livestock storage, food supplies from all the little farms around the area. They may have brought it together here for redistribution, that's one theory. Another theory is it may actually have been a settlement, although it's unlikely to have been settled permanently all year round. It could have been like a seasonal settlement. Of course, it may have been something else altogether. Either way, people have been coming here, gathering and doing stuff here for thousands of years, and they still do. It's astonishing, isn't it? It's wonderful that this is here, just behind these houses, just off the A40, the main road between London and Oxford. It's 4:30, so I think I've got at least a good three and a half hours of daylight, so I'm going to push on into the countryside towards Hedgerley village, and then either up towards Beaconsfield from there, or perhaps down to Wooburn, the village where I grew up. So here, I get a better sense of the scale of the outer ditch. Look, this set of stairs. And remember, it would have been a double ditch. There would have been another one on the other side of this. So it would have been quite an imposing structure. I'm going to take this path now back to Camp Road and pick up a footpath that leads to Hedgerley village. So I'm going to go down another private road here, because down here is the entrance to the footpath that will take me down to Hedgerley, I hope. You know my map reading. Countryside is a delightful place, and I longed to be out in just such a landscape like this today. There is a propensity for farmers to put up signs telling you exactly what you can and can't do on their land. I suppose you can hardly blame them, really. It's a tough job. Now, there is massive scope for me to get lost on the way to Hedgerley and anywhere beyond that. So let's see how we do. I'm going to take this footpath here. It's a landscape to savour, isn't it? Look at that. Sunset tonight is said to be 5 to 8. And this time of year, the walks you do are always have a special feel to them. They're always memorable, these first walks of the long evenings. That's one of the reasons I wanted to come out somewhere like this today. Not that it would have particularly mattered if I'd been somewhere more urban, but it's that idea of striking out beyond the city limits, into the countryside just beyond, just outside of that. And I'm so glad I did come out here today. I nearly didn't. I procrastinated and procrastinated where to go. I was talking to my wife about it, and in the end she went, just do it for yourself. Go where you want to go. Just do it for the love of it. Don't think about a destination or what kind of video you're going to make. Just go where you want to go. So here I am. Isn't this an idyllic scene? Footpath takes me right through those horses and down to Hedgerley village, which I think is where those houses are. Actually, I don't think that is Hedgerley village. There you go. Already I'm getting things wrong. It's a road that will take me to Hedgerley, or could take me up to the A40 in Beaconsfield, but I've got a few hours of daylight. I may as well push on. There is nothing I love more than walking down a narrow country road with no footpath. It's always a little bit edgy. Luckily, there's a footpath now, not far away, and it'll take me across this field, which I've seen many, many times from the M40 up there. I don't think I've ever walked across this field. great filmmaker, Patrick Keeler, wrote a really wonderful book, which I highly recommend, called The View from the Train. And one of his first films, if not his first film, was a film called Stonebridge Park. And it's in the area of London that he had seen from a train going out of London, going out in this direction, really. And there's something about those vistas that you see, either from a moving train or from a car, and they capture the imagination. They're there for a couple of seconds and they're gone, but they lodge themselves in your mind. Those are special places. And this field up here, that field is one such place that I've seen many times going along that road towards Beaconsfield and Wickham and Wooburn. And I've looked at this field, and it's the first symbol that you're back on kind of home territory, the territory that I grew up in. And yet I've never walked here till today. I feel like I'm obliged to do a shot of me walking through this tunnel. I should do a compilation of all the underpass footage I've shot, shouldn't I?
Hey, you.
Got a great bit of pylon action here in the field on the other side of the motorway.
It's funny because the sound of this road is actually incredibly comforting to me in an odd way, because I could hear the distant sound of the road from the house where I grew up as a child, kind of the white noise of the road snuggled and swaddled within the acoustic footprint of the M40.
Pretty sure this is Church Wood, Hedgerley. My dad once told me how he would walk out here with his great mate, Mike Powell, sadly no longer with us, and they would wait for the church bells to ring. And at that point they would shoot the pigeons and the pheasants as they went up to roost in the high boughs of Church Wood, using the church bells as a cover for their shooting. There's a fantastic carpet of bluebells here in Church Wood, Hedgerley. Well, this is a lovely little lane, isn't it? It's going to take me up to Hedgerley village, but we're not actually going to go into the village. We're going to crack on through, I think, to Littleworth Common and head in the direction of Wooburn Green. Hedgerley Church, wonderful old flint church, isn't it? Lots of old Norman churches in this area. It's not particularly unusual to see a 12th or 13th century church around the Chiltern Hills. Hedgerley really is a beautiful little village. Still retained a bit of its old rural charm, although I very much doubt very few of the old inhabitants are still living here. Kind of people my dad used to knock around with. Now along a kiln lane. Wow, what a wonderful lane. 6 o'clock now, just under 2 hours till sunset. Got quite a way to go. Let's hope I can reach Wooburn with some daylight. It's funny that I find myself walking back to the village where I grew up, because it feels like it should be more resonant than it is. But it wasn't my intention today when I left home to do this walk, really. I just wanted to go to Bulstrode Camp and then go somewhere from there. So I wanted to avoid doing a walk to Wooburn Green specifically. I went to Wooburn more last year on the 100th episode, in fact. But I didn't want it to get too mawkish. Something you need to keep those things to yourself, like, don't you? Like that little bit where I grew up. But it just feels the natural place to head towards now, and doesn't feel sentimental or mawkish yet. Let's wait and see. I think I might just miss the footpath back here. No, that wasn't the footpath. I'm going to carry on along Kiln Lane. It's actually such a lovely little country lane, isn't it? If you watch old English films, you'll recognise a lot of the lanes around here. Because we're not that far from Pinewood Studios, there's also Denham Studios as well, very close by. US studios at Beaconsfield, which is now the National School of Film and Television. There are studios at Gerrards Cross as well. So particularly sort of Ealing comedies were shot in these lanes, sort of scenes of people driving cars through the countryside. They use the local stations out here a lot. It's funny, I often spot vistas I recognise in old black and white films. So I've got to traverse this busy road and then I'm going down this lane and striking off Littleworth Common. Here's a great name, Hare Hatch Lane. Fantastic. There we go, into the sunset. My first wood of the day. I've seen some pheasant running around in there. God, the old man would be having a field day. Oh, quite a few footpaths branching off here, which is slightly troubling for me. Let's try and make sure we get the right one. So this is the Portman Estate. Some of the area around here is also owned by the Corporation of London. So there's the thing saying you must stick to the footpath and they won't be responsible for anything that happens to you if you stray from the footpath. Slightly ominous, isn't it? Call of the pheasant. This wood's full of them. There's some absolutely glorious bird song along this path here as I come out of the wood. Come out of the wood into this glorious field. I know I must have really worn out the word glorious today, mustn't I? But I make no apology, because it has been just that. And it's now that last hour of light. As I say every time, this is the part of the walk that lifts the spirits and makes your soul soar above it all. Not sure that's true, it's a bit overly poetic. Quite funny, I rang my dad when I was in that wood back there, half hoping that he would reassure me that I was not that far from Wooburn and would guide me. Although I've got the map and I told him where I was. He was like, "What are you doing there?" And I'd already said to him that I was going to head towards Wooburn. He was like, "Bloody hell, you're nowhere near Wooburn. You've got a bit of a way to go." I think he may be right, but I know which way, I know the route I need to take. It's just a question of whether there's enough daylight to get there. I'm going to go down Boveney Wood Lane now, and that should move us towards Hedzer and Wooburn. What a beautiful little church here. I guess this must be Littleworth Common Church. There you go, it's St Anne's Church, Dropmore. And now through this little gate here along this footpath, and this should take me out very close to the territory of my child and my birth, and Wooburn Common. My nan used to call the people from Wooburn Common furzoppers. Fuzzoppers. Fuzzoppers. as in firs, the dialect name for gorse bushes. People hopping over the gorse bushes, something we didn't do a mile away down in Wooburn Green. Strange, isn't it? Those distinctions meant a lot back in those days. My nan was actually from High Wycombe, I think, originally. I think she was born in Wycombe and then moved to Flackwell Heath. My grandfather on my father's side, I think his family, from what I've been able to tell, pretty much stayed in Wooburn for quite a few generations, I think. I haven't properly looked into it yet, which is something I suppose I should do. Here we go. Here's the firs. Where's the firs hoppers? Hello, this horse has come to say hello.
Hello, you're a friendly chap, aren't you?
What a lovely horse. Just go along the edge, this little patch of woodland there towards Sheepcote Woods and off towards Hedzer and then down to Wooburn Park. Oh, this is a wonderful moment. I didn't think I would actually get here due to my lack of navigation skills, but I believe I just walked straight down here. Then I come into the back of the wood that sits above Wooburn Park. So I may just catch it at sunset if I'm really quick. See that radio tower there? You can see that from the edge of the wood at Wooburn Park. And it always fascinated me as a kid. And I don't think I've ever properly been up there. Maybe only once when I was in the Scouts and we did something in the woods there, like a challenge in the woods at night time. But it was at night time. So here we go, Farm Wood. The final approach down to Wooburn Green. So it's 7:44, 10 minutes till sunset. Just going to head down the edge of the wood here, underneath the radio mast. So this is a great moment. All those years I spent looking at this mast from the bottom of the hill. And here I am, standing right beneath it. Well, so this stile here takes us into a field that takes us back down to Wooburn Park. Possibly the place that has some of the happiest memories for me. Spent all my childhood summers there with my dad when he was playing cricket. And I've got a lovely photograph, actually, of the last time I was here at this point. So down there is Wooburn Park. Place where I spent all my childhood summers with my dad when he was playing cricket for Wooburn Narcovians. Incredibly happy days, wonderful, wonderful memories. And I grew up just a little bit further along the valley in Wooburn there. You can see some twinkling lights. I really couldn't have dreamed of a better ending for a walk today than this. Back in a very special place for me. And I didn't really intend to come out here. So I think I'll end the video here with this lovely view of Wooburn Park just as it's about to get dark, 8 o'clock, on a magical evening. Well, thank you so much for coming on this wonderful walk with me today. It's been a really special one, as I'm sure you can tell. It's about to get dark, so I'll end on a shot of the glorious, majestic Wooburn Park. And then I'm gonna go and find a pint down at the Green, probably in the Queen now, but. So I'll see you on the next walk, wherever that may be. Could be anywhere. Who thought we'd end up here today? Who knows where we'll be next time?